Welcome to Tunacheki's Africa Trending News.
And do people read your books in Nigeria?
They do, shockingly.
They do. Are there bookshops in Nigeria?
You know, I think it reflects very poorly on French people that you have to ask me that question.
I really do. Because, I mean,
because I think surely, I mean, it's 2018, you know, I mean, come on. My books are read in Nigeria. They are, they're studied in schools, actually not just Nigeria, across the continent of Africa. And it means a lot to me because obviously I'm very grateful to be read everywhere in the world, but there's something about being read by the people about whom you write. And some of my writing, the people who've sort of made stage plays of some of the stories in Nigeria. When I wrote Half of the Yellow Sun, I remember doing my first event in Lagos, and it was a full house, and it suddenly turned into people just arguing about history. And I sat back and I just enjoyed it. So people were throwing words at each other. And for me, what was wonderful was that literature had made this happen, that because of this contested part of our history, people had read this book and suddenly they were talking about it and they were disagreeing. But the point is they were having a conversation, and that conversation had been prompted by literature. And so I felt hopeful about it. I think in general that France doesn't seem to realize that it is no longer an 18th century world power. And I say this with sad honesty, because I have affection for the minister left. Oh, okay, good. but I mean, I think that the French, I mean, so I'm Anglophone African, I'm not Francophone, but I think that French, the history of French and Francophone relations, I find very vexed and troubling. I think it's interesting, this idea that the CFA, the Francophone currency, is somehow tied to the French franc. I find that really retrograde. I think that the way that there's a kind of cultural power that France wields over Francophone Africa that I think is unhealthy. I think Francophone films are really French films in a way that's not the case in Anglophone West Africa. There is a kind of, I think the way that Anglophone Africans occupy their space in the UK is not the same way that Francophone Africans occupy their space in France. And, you know, and I think that Francophone Africans who know this, right? And maybe they should be the ones answering this question, because, you know, I know I read a bit about it, but I obviously don't have a personal experience. But I should say that my criticism when I started out, and I stand by it, it's because I've had many unpleasant experiences with French immigration. Yesterday was different because they were actually polite, but every time I have come into France, and it's happened, I'm going to say 4 or 5 times in the past 2 years, there is a kind of contempt with which I am dealt with when I present my Nigerian passport that I really find indefensible. And I think it's important because the immigration officers are the first line of contact with the country, and so it shapes the way you think of a country. And I think it takes very little to be polite and to give people their basic dignity. And if I'm coming into a country and I have everything I need and I am legally there, then surely there's no reason to keep me for 30 minutes asking me ridiculous questions, ignoring me for long periods, and just being an ass. So that's what has shaped my irritation Yeah, I think it's important to remember that all human beings really deserve equal dignity. It shouldn't depend on the passport that we carry.
Did you like our video? Please let us know in the comments below and share our video with friends and family to support the channel.